I want to know how to make our math classes more like mathematics as it's actually practiced by mathematicians. We're all on a journey, and we are all trying to move closer to where we want to be and what kind of teacher we want to be, whether we have that modeled for us as students or not. Becoming the math teacher you wish you'd had, it's jam-packed with ideas. It's definitely written for the teacher who feels a little bit nervous about this discipline, but is ready to undertake the work that it would take to feel better about it, to learn to enjoy teaching math, to look forward to teaching math and love teaching math. I was looking for habits of mind that are essential to this discipline of mathematics. What do mathematicians do? They do things like connect ideas, one idea to another. They ask questions, even though in our schools, kids aren't given the opportunity to ask their own mathematical questions very often. It's part of doing math to pose the problem, not just answer somebody else's problem. What I did in each chapter is I chose one of these habits of mind, and I told a short story from the history of math to contextualize it so that you understand what I'm talking about. And then I take you into several different classroom examples of what does that look like in a second grade in Mattapan or an eighth grade in Falmouth, Maine, or a fifth grade in Traverse City, Michigan. How do teachers actually teach all the content they're supposed to teach and meet all the expectations they're supposed to meet, and also teach kids how to ask questions as part of doing math or connect ideas as part of doing math or use their intuitions in mathematics? I want it to rock your thinking about some things, but just when you're thinking, okay, what do I do with that? How would I do it? I take you right into a classroom and we talk about how would you do it? How did this teacher do it and how might you do it? And why does it work the way it works? There were many teachers who said, I don't really like math. They taught math after third recess. They put it off. And now when I see them in the hallway, they say, I can't wait to tell you what happened in math today. Their whole worldview around teaching math and their identities as mathematicians themselves has evolved tremendously through this work together, which feels really good.